Welcome back. My name is Christian Carvalho from the Food Science Digital Transplant Society. And I'm going to share this session. Good talk will be given by Andrew Lutzecki, also from the Food Science Digital Transplant Society, who will tell us about the exact nutritional structure that we will be using in Europe.
to set times you keep colors, which was then it says that's how we are using to even this. And so you would have the results, it's just a structure that you can present as a part of the team. Now you can also really think that you don't have to learn, so maybe you don't have to learn. And so that's why we have this implementation, because we have a community that can be classified very well. Let's have a look at what the classic fingerprint looks like. So here you have the FTC cursor. And you see that the fingerprint is essentially dependent on the size and volume with respect to how big the screen is. Here you see the points are always in the same location. It just gets more narrower because of the information principle. It's nice for our learning. And there are also robots that we expect to represent one structure, two is in the structure, with the same one, and the other is effective one. And they are quite similar to the other one. And they are different to the code, and we are looking at them. And so, this is how they insight for the way this is a structure that can be mentioned by the platform. And we're able to distinguish all the pieces of structure apart from the rules and the platform. That all the entities are quite similar in the real space, so that they are able to distinguish them. But of course, before the others are able to distinguish us, it's also very simple. And so now we are constructing this structure, which is taken from the mobile archive, and then I represent it using the structure field. Now we want to classify fields. And this is our method that we can train to access the rules. So we are going to use a particular convolution neural network that is a type of architecture that we use to classify the rules. I think we want to do this. The reason why it's a method is I don't know if you can use the method too much, but it's a great job in trying to work the steps and then you must define neural network. So here this is one slide to break out. And so what is under any neural network? This is the applies to the series of linear and multi-linear transformations. One of the other. So here you have the framework, which is the object. And then you have 31, which is the first transformation. This is here. You have biases, you have outputs, and you have outputs. Sorry, these are weights. These are weights, plus biases, and you have outputs. But this is the affine transformation. And then you apply the linearity. And this one we are going to be very useful. So, we have to talk about the agency model, for example, and the rules of 24 because it seems to be the rules that in the next is sort of the maximum zero. So, it's a very simple one in variety, but it really allows the method to learn very helpful structure. And it was actually being successful in the past, computer vision, basic motion, For example, how do you know the person to be wise and how to be wise from your experience in the world? You don't have the same computer. And so we want to run the computer every time we run the algorithm, the computer is more natural, right? It's an experience. So we just want to learn low level features, so X and Y. And then through lots of data, we want to build more, I mean, more high level features, combining these low level. And that's why you need a lot of things in your network that you can see. You can see your results in your network with more than one person. Or three or four. You really need to see it. And here's how you complete the convolution. So it's very simple to get an input here. You can tell it. And then you find the coordinate for the instrument is selected. we would be like, okay, and if you were to change it, you would try to create the end of the trial of the institution. And then some day, and that's your output, or that's our technology. You get to see by the data, and then you'll decide to use money. And then the returns you get to the returns, you use the money, and then it's easier to zero, 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 one, and then there are lots of things you can see that you'll last the events or 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 the the good thing is that when you just have a very big, very small turn, you can really stop and remove features from the beginning. For example, here, you have a turn that is the entity, so one is like 0 and the 1 here, and then you get back to the original number, which is the point. Here, you just put the mark right here, and then you apply this turn. Here, if you apply this turn, then you get a word. That seems like it's like genetics, and the gene really is like. And you see this further, that then you can see 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 that game is typically used for the same. And these are the same. Now, the trick is that if you have a motion under the circle, you know, you can use the motion to make the circle. And then you make the circle to the circle. Now, the trick is that you have a motion under the circle, you learn the circle. You do not use the circle. It's how to learn that to the circle. So, you can make it faster. And so, the practice is what is done with this part of the information and the information. So, two things to remember, the complexity of the features is being created by the features. The features are minimized. And that's what the other part of the learning is minimizing the same. So, to remember this, in particular, the complexity of the features, you will come up with it. And I show you that I'm showing the books that you can find. Which is not an important step in science paper, but it is just how they are implementing our design tool. And so now we look at the use case. The use case, I think, so I took the initial data set from the part line, and this contains 7 classes of number of children before, and it's roughly 10,000 structures, 10,000 species. And then I divide it by 90% in training and 10% in evaluation. And then I can evaluate it on some method. And then they're able to get 100% training and evaluation of course. So they're able to learn and to classify correctly. But we are not, we want to go further, so we have to think about it. So we want to see how we can standardize things, like one thing and effective function. So what I did is I did this to my network, and I don't really think that I just did it like this. And then I generate another set of useful function, but now every effective one. So we only have up to 25% of the outcomes, for example, or this very good outcome. And then I can use the neural network from before, only 100,000. And without retraining, then I still get 100% question. For example, that we can generalize to fractures that are far away from the test set, which are really good. And then you can also play around down here with network, you can also play around with, you know, to exploit the weakness of this network. So you can generate a weight structure. And you have some parameters, you want alpha, is the blackness, the end of the blackness actually. It turns out that for some particular angle, so if alpha is 109.47, then you really degenerate to the region 6. And therefore, if you have 90 degrees, then you get 2.3. And for the other case, it's always a point. It's always the left, so we try to make it quite something in the top low. And then I use a magnetic equation. And then you see that it's actually what you would like to see. So you have the neural network is always predicted as an example. Apart from it, it's very, you know, it's the same point that the brain from actually the other point that you can see as a simple tool. And now, okay, so now the deck box, we want to open the deck box because the neural network are deck box on certain times, so they're either the top of the particle. So we want to see why the neural network are part of the system. So how do we do that? We essentially, here we want to be able to say to propagate to human states what where the information that was learned from the network. So essentially, we can be able to prove that the neural network is not connected and classified data. And you can see this very easily. It was a paper from the machinery community in 2014. We can use this method to do so. And we came up with that from our research. We applied that to many things. And now we want to do it, we're going to apply the neural network to the distribution. And so here is our image. So it's going to be structured. And then you see the first layer, the neural network, is the most important part of the image. Here you see that the network has to get the shape of the box. But it's not the right thing to do, because you know, if we look where the points are, you know, the right evolution of the box, not the shape of the box. But hopefully the network will turn back to the layer. And then, here not quite, but already the third layer, you see the network is going to be looking at the So what do you think the neural network learn? So essentially, the most important part of the network rules for the distribution, you see that the network really learns templates from the data. These are really different forms of data. And so the network learns a template from the data, and actually it's the same landmark of person who uses the classifier. And if you give a different type of image, then you will learn different ways, but the feature is actually the same. So, this brings me to the conclusion. So, I introduced the challenge, how to represent the differences of our past, and what are complements, and hopefully, we will move in a little bit the black box. I will be around some questions, and also be around with the more, so we'll just go through the comments of the past. Thank you.
It's a very nice talk, thank you. So the classification, I understand, is very useful, but how do you find classifying things that are more, could be more useful for certain aspects of material science, like textures and texture material, then the diffraction pattern will change a bit. So it's fairly clear. I mean, even with eyes, you can see clearly that the BCC heads, are quite different. So it's quite believable that the neural network is here. But how is it to deformations and textures in particular directions? And whether a neural network can actually tell you how a texture material is in a particular direction? Strains and
Here, I understand that you can classify by eye, but you can see even the representation. This is material big data, you cannot classify by eye under thousands, right? Now, once the charging sector, you will assume that the
characteristics
are the same. Yeah. Where's that? 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 different team of things that you would have with the 10 cities or 10 countries. You make a lot of presentations for this. So, you can enter the schedule, you know, what you need to be asking, you see, and not that you see, and you know, it's going to be not to be able to do what the reason is also going to be like.
I'm going to have one question. I'm going to win here. I'm going to take a five.